My dear students, today I will talk about the intercostal muscles and the diaphragm. But before talking about the intercostal muscles, let us identify the contents of the intercostal space. This is a rib, this is another rib, and this is the intercostal space. This intercostal space contains intercostal muscles, arranged in three layers: external intercostal, internal intercostal, and the transversus thoracis, or innermost intercostal muscle. And intercostal vessels, intercostal arteries, and intercostal veins, and then intercostal nerve. And remember the arrangement of the intercostal vessels and the nerve: vein, intercostal vein above, intercostal artery in the middle, and the intercostal nerve is the lowest part. Let us start by the intercostal muscles. Intercostal muscles are arranged in three layers. Outer layer is the external intercostal muscle. Middle layer is the internal intercostal muscle. And the inner layer is the transversus thoracis. It is arranged into three parts. The anterior part behind the sternum is the sternocostalis. The middle part is the innermost intercostal muscle, this one. And the posterior part is the subcostalis muscle. Start by the external and the internal intercostal muscles. This is the external intercostal muscle, and this is the internal intercostal muscle. External intercostal muscle arises from the lower border of the rib above to the upper border of the rib below. Internal intercostal muscle arises from the lower border of the rib above to the upper border of the rib below to the upper border to the lower border of the rib above. The direction of fibers: external oblique is downward and medially, internal oblique is upward and medially. Okay, the external oblique extends from the tubercle of the rib posteriorly till the costochondral junction, where it is completed by the anterior intercostal membrane or external intercostal membrane. So it arises from the external intercostal, arises from lower border of the upper lip to the upper border of the lower lip. It extends from the tubercle of the rib posteriorly, okay, and continues to the costochondral junction, where it is completed by the external intercostal membrane or the anterior intercostal membrane. The function or the action of the external intercostal is elevation of the ribs. Elevation of the ribs during inspiration. So the external intercostal muscle is a muscle of inspiration. The main muscle of inspiration is the diaphragm. The internal intercostal muscle, okay, it arises from the upper border of one rib to the lower border of the previous rib. Okay, it extends from the sternum. Okay, it extends from the sternum till the angle of the rib, where it is completed by the posterior intercostal membrane. And the action of the internal intercostal muscle is depression of the ribs, expiration. So what should you know about the external intercostal and the internal intercostal? External intercostal is completed anteriorly by the external intercostal membrane or the anterior intercostal membrane. Internal intercostal muscle is completed posteriorly by the posterior intercostal membrane or the internal intercostal membrane. The action the external intercostal elevation of the ribs, the internal intercostal depression of the ribs. Therefore, the external intercostal is muscle of inspiration, the internal intercostal is muscle of expiration. This is the thoracic cage, sternum and ribs, elevation and depression. So which muscle elevates the ribs? It is the external intercostal muscle. It is the muscle of inspiration, elevation of the ribs. Now, depression of the ribs. All the other intercostal muscles. So depression of the ribs is performed by internal intercostal and the other muscles. Other muscles like what? Like innermost intercostal, sternocostalis, and the subcostalis. So what is the muscle of inspiration? External intercostal. Muscles of expiration, internal intercostal, innermost intercostal, sternocostalis, and the subcostalis. Okay? These are the ribs. This is the intercostal space. This is external intercostal muscle. It is completed anteriorly by the anterior intercostal membrane or the posterior intercostal membrane. Okay, so external intercostal membrane or anterior intercostal membrane. Here, this is the innermost intercostal muscle, and this membrane is the posterior intercostal membrane, which is a continuation of the internal intercostal muscle. This is the external intercostal, internal intercostal, and the innermost intercostal. Actually, one of the landmarks of the internal intercostal is that the intercostal nerve pierces the internal intercostal and divides it into two layers. The outer layer is the internal intercostal muscle proper, and the inner layer is the innermost intercostal muscle. Okay, again, this is the external intercostal muscle. This is the external intercostal membrane or the anterior intercostal membrane. This is the innermost intercostal muscle. This is the internal intercostal membrane or the posterior intercostal membrane. And this is the intercostal nerve splitting the internal intercostal muscle into innermost intercostal and the internal intercostal. So what is this membrane? It is the external intercostal membrane. What is the origin? It is the continuation of the external intercostal. What is this membrane? It is the posterior or internal intercostal membrane. What is the origin of this membrane? It is the continuation of the internal intercostal muscle. Now the transversal thoracis. Three muscles. The anterior one is the sternocostalis. The middle one is the innermost intercostal. And the posterior one is the subcostalis. Actually, what you should know about the three muscles is the action. Just only the action. The action of these three muscles, depression of the ribs during expiration. Sternocostalis arises from the back of the sternum. It is, okay, it is inserted into the ribs. Ribs from number 2 to number 6. Innermost intercostal, it is the inner layer of the internal intercostal muscle, and the subcostalis, it extends between two ribs posteriorly. And the action of these muscles, depression of the ribs during expiration. So, what are the muscles of respiration? Inspiration, the main muscle is the diaphragm plus external intercostal muscle. How about depression of the ribs? The other intercostal muscles, which are internal intercostal, innermost intercostal, sternocostalis, subcostalis. What are the accessory muscles of respiration? Actually, muscles above the thorax, muscles in the neck, the action is elevation of the ribs. So they assist in inspiration. Anterior abdominal wall muscles, which are located below the ribs, so the action is depression of the ribs, so they assist in expiration. So, muscles of inspiration, diaphragm and external intercostal, assisted by muscles in the neck. inspiration. Internal intercostal, innermost intercostal, sternocostalis, subcostalis, assisted by muscles of the anterior abdominal wall. Now let us talk about the diaphragm. This is the diaphragm or abdominal diaphragm or diaphragm of thoracic outlet. Let's talk about the origin, talk about the insertion, talk about the nerve supply, the action, and the three major openings of the diaphragm. This is the diaphragm closing the thoracic outlet. So start by the origin. Diaphragm, it must close the thoracic outlet. So it has external origin from the back of the xiphoid process. It has costal origin from the lower six costal cartilages. It has vertebral origin. So three origin: external, costal, and the vertebral. And the vertebral origin is by two crurii and arcuate ligaments. Two crurii, one left and one right. Left crus from the upper two, okay, start by the right crus. Right crus from the upper three lumbar vertebrae, the buddies. Left crus from the upper two. Therefore, the right crus is stronger than the left crus because the right half of the diaphragm is related to the liver. Then arcuate ligaments, three. Median, medial, and lateral. Median arcuate ligament extends between the two crurii. Medial arcuate ligament between each crus and the tip of L1 transverse process. And lateral arcuate ligament from the tip of L1 transverse process to the last rib. So again, origin, external, costal, vertebral, and the vertebral, right crus and left crus, and the three arcuate ligaments, median, medial, and lateral, then the nerve supply. Okay, insertion into the central tendon. This is the central tendon. Okay, nerve supply, motor and sensory. The motor nerve supply is the phrenic nerve, which arises from C3, 4, and 5. Sensory, the central part of the diaphragm receives the sensory fibers from the phrenic nerve and the peripheral fibers from the lower five intercostal nerves. The action of the diaphragm, it is the main muscle of inspiration. Now let us talk about the major openings of the diaphragm. We have three. This is the first one for the inferior vena cava, vena caval opening. This is the second one for the esophagus, esophageal opening. And this is the third one for the aorta. This is the aortic opening. What should you know about these openings? First, the vertebral level. Remember, 8, 10, 12. The vena caval opening is opposite T8. Esophageal opening is opposite T10. Aortic opening is opposite T12. So this is the vertebral level. The highest one is the vena caval opening, opposite T8. The lowest one is the aortic opening, is opposite T12. 8, 10, and 12. Then the relation of each opening in the midline, or where is each one? Where is each one? The vena caval opening is in the central tendon, 1 inch to the right of the midline. The esophageal opening in the right crus, 1 inch to the left. And the aortic opening behind the median arcuate ligament in the midline. So we have one in the midline, which is the aortic opening. One to the right, the vena caval opening. One to the left is the esophageal opening. Why the vena caval opening is present in the central tendon? to dilate the inferior vena cava during contraction of the diaphragm and increase the venous return. Why the esophageal opening is present in the right crest? Because actually the esophagus doesn't have anatomical sphincter. So the right crest acts as a sphincter for the esophagus. Why the aortic opening is present behind the median arcuate ligament to protect the aorta from the contraction of the diaphragm. Then what are the structures passing through each foramen? Each foramen transmits three structures. The vena cava opening, of course, it transmits the inferior vena cava, the right phrenic nerve, and the lymphatics from the liver to the mediastinal lymph nodes. So the vena cava opening transmits inferior vena cava, right phrenic nerve, lymphatics from the liver. Esophageal opening, of course, the esophagus. Right and left vagus, which are called anterior and posterior gastric nerves, and the branch from the left gastric artery to supply the esophagus. The aortic opening of the diaphragm transmits three structures, of course, the aorta, the thoracic duct, and the azygous vein. And thank you very much. Good luck, best wishes, and see you again.